RobinReaction.com.
In this video, I'll be going over the differences between homogeneous mixtures and heterogeneous mixtures. And so first we're going to go over some definitions and look at this chart, and then I'll do some practice problems. So starting off, even though this video is just going to focus in on the right-hand side, which is mixtures, let's go ahead and just do a quick review. All right, so let's start off with all matter, which is basically everything you're going to see in your life except for energy, which is things like light and heat. But for the most part, when you think to yourself, hey, I'm really seeing something right now, you're looking at matter. And so inside matter, we have two groups: pure substances, which are either elements, like on the periodic table, or compounds, which is mostly saying molecules. So for instance, all of these are H2O molecules. But basically, pure substances are saying you have one thing. All right, so now let's go ahead and define mixtures. And so in this, we have homogeneous and heterogeneous. So overall, mixtures are a random blend of two or more substances. They have no unique physical properties, and they can be physically separated. So a random blend of two or more substances. Basically, we have more than one type of atom or more than one type of molecule, and it has no unique physical properties. That's talking about things like boiling point, melting point, or density, those kind of inherent qualities. We wouldn't say that mixtures always have those, because really we could have a different type of mixture, right? You could have the same two things and have it be 50-50, or you could have it be 70-30. And so just the difference between those two things is going to change the melting point, boiling point, density, etc. So we never say mixtures have these physical properties. And then we can also say that they can be physically separated, because they do have different atoms that do have different physical properties. Sometimes in a mixture, you can just filter things away. Sometimes you can boil off one molecule before you boil off a different one. But basically, you don't have to always do chemistry and change the bonds to separate the mixtures. You can do other types of things that don't involve changing the actual molecules. Okay, so now we kind of know what a mixture is, and now let's get into homogeneous, which means evenly mixed, which means you can't see the different parts, and that's our example right here. And so we can really look in at our green and orange example and say, okay, for the most part, now of course it's not going to be exact, but for the most part, if you're looking at this example, you're not going to say, oh, the oranges are in one location and the greens are in another. For the most part, it's mixed around. That means homogeneous. And that's in contrast with heterogeneous, which is unevenly mixed, which means you can see the different part. So an example of this is like oil and water. If you pour oil and water together, you can clearly see, yep, that's where the oil is, yep, that's where the water is. Even if you shake it up, you're still going to see those beads of water and oil that are separate from each other. And in this little case, doesn't matter what the two molecules or atoms are, but we can clearly see that purple is generally on the bottom and that the green and blue one is generally on top. So if we were zoomed out and this was something that was visible to the human eye, we'd be able to see, yeah, that looks like two different things. All right, so now let's go ahead and do these practice problems. So first, we have coffee. So with all of these, we know we're not going to do elements or compounds. We're just on mixtures, and coffee is a mixture. But it's pretty homogeneous, right? When you stare at coffee, it pretty much looks like brown liquid. It doesn't look like it has a bunch of different parts. So I would say the only alternative answer to this is if you had something like Turkish coffee, where there's a ton of the beans ground up still at the bottom, or if you have some kind of reason why it doesn't look like all one thing. But for the most part, coffee is going to be homogeneous. So now let's do our second example of gasoline. And so gasoline, once again, we know it's not just, you can't look at the periodic table and see, oh yeah, there's the gasoline element. We know it's more than one thing. So it's usually a bunch of different hydrocarbons mixed together. So we know it's a mixture. And then looking at it carefully, it again just kind of looks like a liquid, right? So we would also say this is homogeneous, because you can't look at it and say, yep, that's where this 6-carbon hydrocarbon is, and that's where this 8-carbon hydrocarbon is, right? It's not immediately like that. It looks like it's all just one thing. We just know it's a mixture of different types of molecules. So now I included this example, blood, because I've seen a lot of practice problems and textbooks go over this. So this is actually heterogeneous. And so I think this can be a little bit confusing because the other two examples we just did were considered homogeneous and they're just liquids, and blood can definitely look homogeneous. I included the answer as heterogeneous because that's what textbooks and practice problems always do in class. And I think what it's wanting you to do is to be like, oh, if it like clots in a certain place, then it becomes heterogeneous. If you really had a lot of blood and were staring at it, I don't know why this would be happening. You can see that some places are a little bit more consistent than others. I kind of think it's a bad example because it's not clearly heterogeneous, but I wanted to include it just to kind of explain it. And also, a lot of these things are arguably, you could say it's the opposite way. You could really make a point to say that coffee is heterogeneous if you include any coffee bean that's at the bottom. That would make it a heterogeneous mixture. But, you know, there's a cutoff point. A lot of these things kind of involve assumptions. And so it gets a little bit hard to tell exactly where the cutoff point is for homo or heterogeneous. All right. So next, let's do vodka. So once again, it's a liquid and it pretty much all looks like one thing, but we know that vodka isn't just one element or one compound, it's a mixture, so it's going to be homogeneous. And so next, milk and cereal, this is clearly heterogeneous, right? We can look at it and see, obviously, milk and cereal are not the same consistency. They're not blended together. This is a mixture, and we can see different parts. It's unevenly mixed. And that's the same thing for stew, right? That's also heterogeneous. Lots of different parts. It's not just one thing. All right, hope this video helped you tell the difference between homo and heterogeneous mixtures. Again, this is a lot of assumptions, and you know, you could see slightly different answers out there, but in general, as long like the rules are evenly mixed and unevenly mixed, it just depends on whoever is grading or doing the practice set on what they consider super evenly mixed or unevenly mixed. All right, bye.
Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to like, comment, or subscribe. And if you go to my website, I have a ton of free practice problems you can check out. And if you need even more help, you can hire me for one-on-one private tutoring sessions that are online. All right, thanks. That's it. Happy studying.